You both have Camillas in your life, yes. Both of you.
Yes, and we do.
Shawn, it was 5 years ago that you were here on the show and you were on with Camila, and I asked if you two were dating, and I've never seen a more unconvincing denial. Have a look. Are you two dating?
That's very unconvincing.
No. Okay.
No, we're not.
So you're saying no. Can I be honest?
What?
I don't believe you. Let's get to the bottom of this now. So you're saying...
No. We're actually... No. We're just kidding. We're actually...
But anyway, at the end of the day, we're not dating. We're just...
No, we're not.
You're both being very defensive, right?
So don't show us.
Sounds to me like you both might love each other. You don't know how to commit. Am I right?
It sounds like we both made out and we're just
totally... There's no way you haven't made out. You totally have.
We really haven't.
I don't believe you, though.
I don't care.
How does it feel, Shawn, watching that back?
It's hard. It's really hard. I had to take some real deep breaths and hear Matthew McConaughey in the back of my head saying, "You're going to be okay." Because I remember that. That was so hard. I mean, I didn't even accept that I was completely in love with her for another 3 years after that point. But it's so obvious on my face right there.
Really? It was 3 years after that you realized that you had feelings for each other and everything changed?
I think 3 years after that is when I'd finally admitted, and then another 2 years after that is when I decided to do something about it. So now this is where that kind of took me. But
I mean,
the timing kind of worked out. Yeah, look at me now. We're good. Everything's amazing.
Aww. Yes. Everything is amazing. It's so nice. Terrific. It is. And like, Matthew, did you know, with your Camila, did you know straight away that she was the one for you?
Here's what I knew. I remember... I saw this figure moving across the room from my right to left, and it's like her head was not even bobbing. It was like she was floating. And I remember, without thinking about it, leaning up in my chair and saying to myself, I didn't say, "Who is that?" I said, "What is that?" And I remember trying to call her over from across the room, and just as I was trying to call her over, I heard this voice in my other ear, and it was my mother talking to me back when I was 18 years old, going, "This is not the type of woman you wave across the club to. Get your butt up and go introduce yourself." So I did, and that night I spoke the best Portuguese I've ever spoken in my life and understood Portuguese better than I've ever understood in my life. But it was about 2 years later that I really fell in love with her. We were in Papua New Guinea at a surf retreat, living in this treehouse. We were having our first cocktail of the evening, watching the sunset over the Solomon Sea. And I got up the courage to go, "Hey, what would I ever have to do to lose you?" And Camila, cool as could be, drink in hand, didn't even stutter, didn't even flinch her hand, took a little sip, set it back down, and said, "Oh, that's easy." And then she turned to me and looked me in the eye, and she goes, "Change." And I went, oh, yes, you're the one, yes. Yes, that's when I fell in love with her. That's when I said, "This is definitely the woman I want to spend the rest of my life with. This is definitely the woman I want to be the mother of my children." And hey, as Shawn said with his Camila, with me and mine, we're still going strong.